This is not an accident. This is nature's natural immune vaccination system. I'll give you one significant insight into this that comes from us in 1986 when the swine flu epidemic scared everybody. And the significance was that all of a sudden the government felt that it was necessary to inject everybody with a vaccine against the swine flu. And the problem was nobody tested this vaccine. And while they were creating all these vaccines, insurance companies started to step away from the government and said, wait a minute, you're going to inject the entire population with vaccines that haven't really fully been tested? The insurance companies balked and said, we're not even going to cover that. The government actually had to change the Constitution in the United States because by definition, the Constitution, the government can't be an insurer of the people. And yet, the insurance company said they're not going to cover this government-mandated vaccine. So the government said, okay, we'll cover it. And guess what? There was no real swine flu epidemic at all. But it cost the government billions of dollars in insurance for a simple reason. The vaccines killed many more people than the so-called swine flu that really didn't exist. And the vaccines created a situation called Guillain-Barré syndrome, which is a destruction of the nervous system as a result of the vaccinations. And you start to realize, oh my God, the vaccinations were much more toxic than the so-called swine flu. Immunology has made a misunderstanding about something very important called the tonsils. We have all heard of tonsils, and many of us have had our tonsils taken out. If you look in a conventional book, a tonsil represents an immune mechanism that will protect us from invasive organisms. And the tonsils, there's actually three pairs or six tonsils making a ring around your throat. And the significance of the tonsils is they are the devices that apparently are protecting us, and I use that with quotes, from foreign things such as viruses or bacteria that enter through our mouth, our nose, our eyes, or our ears, because all of these structures have conduits that connect to the throat. So if an invasive organism enters into our body through any of the holes in our head, these organisms must pass through the ring of the tonsils. It was believed and still believed by many that these tonsils represent the first line of defense to protect us against these invasive organisms. It's time to reconsider this concept completely for this reason. When we say that tonsils are there for our defense, then you would think, well, tonsils are there to protect us from anything that gets on the inside. Tonsils actually invite antigens into the body. And all of a sudden, what do you mean invite them? I thought they were supposed to protect me. Well, all the tonsils have little tiny slivers of connection to the surface so that as we eat something or something goes down our throat, a small sample of what we just swallowed goes down these little crevices and enter into the tonsils. The function of the tonsils is then to read the nature of these things that we brought into our mouth and then identify them by creating antibodies that will complement with these foreign things introduced into the body. By this mechanism, the immune system then gets to sample everything that comes in through the apertures in our head and passes through our throat. Not only does it sample it, but it's a place where we set up a learning system. This is where we teach the immune system to recognize the things in our environment. And so basically, the tonsils are not protective mechanisms in that regard against an infection. The tonsils are a place of immunological learning because we invite the antigens in so we can create antibodies against them. By definition, the tonsils are designed for oral vaccination, meaning anything you put into your mouth, the tonsils will facilitate an immune response against anything that's not part of your normal body. When you bypass the natural mechanism and insert the antigens under the skin, you fool the system because at all entry points to the body, the system has sentry guards to see what's coming into the body and create an awareness of it for the system of what's in there. If you go underneath the skin, you begin to introduce something that there are no sentries for. No guides to say, hey, what happened in this area? All of a sudden, there are antigens that showed up. How'd they get here? Not through any normal way that the body knows. So the first thing is you trick the immune system. but not in a natural way. You've confused it. The natural way is orally to bring something into the body. So when it comes to vaccinations, please realize, nature already gave us a vaccination system. What we should have our scientists do is focus on how we can best use that system rather than trying to avoid it entirely and inject vaccines under our skin.